Starting off with a 5x5 canvas in inches. We're just gonna go over and find the image I'd like to use. Once you do that, remove the background. So just give that a moment. Then we're gonna go over into our text. We're gonna create whatever it is that you want. I am going to use Merry Christmas. So this part is about preference. I am gonna change my font. Once you do that, you're just gonna go back into effects. You're gonna go to curve and you're gonna adjust it however it is that you like. I was considering doing it this way, but then I'm like, for this tutorial, I wasn't really feeling it. So let's do it this way. And you just have to play around with it a little bit, adjust it however it is that you like it once again. Then I'm just gonna go over and I'm gonna change the color into white. Then you're gonna outline next. Okay, so I'm just gonna duplicate Mary just to keep it simple. I'm typing in Christmas. Once you do that, we're just gonna go back into effects and we're gonna adjust the curve, fix it however it is that you like it. You don't want to put it too far and you don't want to put it too close, and you'll see why later on. Now we're going to duplicate the image. This will create a three-dimensional look opposed to the sticker just looking flat. So click layers, and once you do that, you just rearrange it to how it is that you like it. Okay, so now we're just gonna change the aspect ratio. You do that by clicking the image. Then all you're gonna do is just adjust the top layer, which is the image that we duplicated. And we're just gonna just fiddle around until we figure out, you know, what looks good for us. I want my scarf to peek out. If you're picky and you want the word to show, all you have to do is duplicate Christmas one more time, go back into effect and do the outline feature and put it over Christmas. That this way you'll be able to see the full word and also still have the peak of the scarf. So now we're gonna just download. Make sure you do transparent background. Once you download it, just re-upload it. And I'll just like to take this time out to say thank you guys for watching my videos. If I missed any details or if there's anything else that you would like me to go over, please leave it in the comment section. Like and subscribe if you don't mind. It will help me out a lot. Okay, so let's continue. So now that we have it uploaded, I am just going to add another page. Re-upload, and then once you have it uploaded, we're just going to narrow it down a little bit so we have a little bit more space to work with, and then we're going to adjust the image. Okay, so now all we're going to do is we're going to enlarge the image to fit the canvas, and then we are going to duplicate the image. Once you do that, we are going to go into edits and we're going to go into Duotone. Go to custom. And we're going to click the top one and make everything black. So the top and bottom is going to be black. Then you're going to go back and go into blur. We're going to set the intensity to 80. Then you're going to exit. And we're just going to reposition the image over the blur. Adjust it again however you want. This is preference. Once we do that, go back into edits. This time we're going to work with shadows. Go to outline and you're going to adjust the sizing to however it is that you would prefer your outline. I am going to go with 30. You could also change the color. It depends on your branding or, you know, whatever color it is you like, whatever. I'm going to stick with white and just select everything and group. Let's move on to the next. So for this image, it's a PNG. You don't have to remove anything or download anything. We're just going to duplicate it. We're going to go into edit. We're going to go back into Duotone. We're going to go to custom. We're going to change top and bottom into black. We're going to go back and change the blur. I'm going to make this 81. So basically, it's the same as the first one. The only difference is you don't have to remove the background. So again, once you do that, you go into the shadows. You do your outline. Once you do your outline, you're just going to adjust the sizing to however it is that you like it. Once you adjust the sizing, you're going to fit it. This one kind of had a... this had a black line for some reason, so all I did was go into background remover, which is the BG remover at the top. And once you do that, all I'm going to do is just play around with it once more and adjust it. So I'm going to play some music for this one and let you guys watch the process. Okay, so for this one, I didn't add a blur, just an outline. So for those that don't like the blur, you don't have to add the blur. But for those that do prefer the blur, all we're going to do is duplicate the page, and I am going to show you how it is that you add the blur to this one. Okay, so we're going to go into duotone. We're going to do black and white, but as you can see, it still has the pink outline, so we are just going to go back into the shadows and we're going to remove the outline. Okay, so from the iPad that I'm using, I'm not able to select everything all at once. So for this, you're just selecting the shadow. And then you're going to click on the top one, and then you'll be able to group it one time. If you're using the computer, you just select everything and just group. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching. Bye!